Sure, I don't sleep. Rain, sleet, hail, it doesn't matter. We're out here, we're doing it. Today, we have the Haydenshapes Cohort 1. It's part of their new cohort series, which is named after an ancient Roman military unit.
We have you surrounded. Lay down your weapons.
Come and get them!
Formation!
As far as how the board looks and feels, it's a pretty nondescript, standard, but beautiful shortboard. Feels good under the arm, it's got a decent amount of rocker through the nose, and foam's evenly distributed throughout the board, so it just looks like something that you could get on and go. This board's PU, so it's got polyurethane foam, and polyester resin, yeah. It's polyurethane foam and polyester glass. Whatever, who the fuck cares? The two main guys we've seen riding this board are Mickey Clark and Craig Anderson. Mickey's brought it to Waco and he's also surfed at home in California. And Craig Anderson has surfed his cohort in some beautiful winter waves in Australia. The idea behind the cohort series is it's kind of like an army in that they cover all of these different positions.
So the cohort one would kind of be like the general. It's sturdy, reliable, and can handle most things the ocean throws at it. Eventually, the cohort line will expand to include everything from heavy artillery to infantrymen who are out there groveling in the trenches.
I'm gonna see if this rain clears up and we can maybe find some waves after the storm passes. Rain didn't stop, but off we go.
Ooh! It's way more offshore than sideshore. Oh, we could be on, Jetty. That just got me excited. I did not expect that.
So fucking psyched. It's like trying to go offshore. Oh my god, look at that thing!
Shout out to Surfline for calling today Port Affair. Basically got to surf the best waves that I've seen in months with just one friend out. The rain never stopped, but the wind went offshore and we scored. Yeah, the only thing better than surfing perfect waves with your friend is doing it on a new board that you end up really liking. It took me a little bit to figure out where to kind of put my feet and how to turn it, but once I did, I feel like I really kind of locked in. And I was able to link some maneuvers together and really flow with it. Like it had a really nice flow in the wave. The rocker was interesting. It was kind of like a blessing and a curse because with the strong offshores, it would sometimes get like caught up in the wind a little bit, but then it would also help me on like a late drop. These are the Beta 2.0 fins and they're kind of like the precursor to a new fin construction that Futurist is coming out with soon. they're made from carbon, so they're really light, but they're also really stiff. So there were a couple times where I just felt like I couldn't get that tight snap that I needed, and I got a little bit stuck. So next session, I'm gonna try a fin that's just a little bit looser, maybe a little bit more flexible, and see if that feels a bit better.
Walking, talking to friendly faces in my aces. Drinking beer, smoking BDs in the back with the bases. The place is packed, doubly stacked with ladies of nice acid. The only ice rocked is in glasses. I move on, the DJ rocks a new song. People flooding the dance floor just to get their groove on. To that old funky and tough, the speaker bump up. JB horns blowing, they throwing some black stuff. And the crowd goes nuts like a disco dream. Series of protests, candle lit, table is clean. The brown wicker chair looking like Al Green. Sitting back, legs crossed, straight checking out the scene.
Oh no.
Crowd looking and slinging to Eddie Vaughn while I'm walking to the bar, cause my drink's getting low. I need a Long Island iced tea, double no ice. Something fruity for these two cuties, cause they look nice.
They giggle
and they whisper, her friend called me mister. That's one of the pieces getting geek, so I kissed her on the cheek, double step in.
Yeah, what's up, y'all?
I see these pretty dudes eyeballing from the wall, and I step back. Man. This is a family party, we don't act ill. So I'ma tell these young punks that they gots to chill.
Whoa, they say the bigger the headache, the bigger the pill. People under the staircase, drop your feel. I'm smelling like dope and I'm shooting for more. Eyes glued to the nigga, moving slow on the floor. I say she hella sexy and her friends were
marking. Alright, well, that devolved quickly. I thought we were gonna get to go and surf this fun little right hand point break running down the sand, and it was kind of like that for a minute, and then the wind sort of switched and started pushing these swells up the face, and yeah, it got really tricky, but it's the way the cookie crumbles. So the board is, as we expected, not quite a groveler. When I did happen to get a good steeper section, it performed well. I could get a good crack off the lip or a little carve into the pocket, but when I was forced to go between the actual parts of the wave that were standing up, it just didn't quite have the planing ability to get over those flat sections, which is basically to be expected of a board of this genre.
While the Cohort 1 is technically an all-arounder, in my opinion, it's more geared toward high-quality waves than it is whatever we just surfed.
My pride's tougher than that. My niggas kicking raps in the corner.
I will say, though, that the fins helped a lot on the smaller waves. These fins are really flexible, and actually a little bit too flexible sometimes. Like, there are a couple turns where I felt them sliding out. So the difference between these fins and the other fins that I rode is pretty crazy. This is, I'd say, too far on the flex scale for this sort of board, especially if I was gonna surf it in better waves. But they did help out a lot in these smaller, crappier conditions. Overall, board works really, really well in good waves. Not so great in average waves.
In reality, we all know that, you know, each board has its own little sweet spot when it comes to conditions, and I think I'll be saving this one for days that are at least head high with a little bit of cup in the face.
So, Cohort 1, next time the waves are pumping, this is the board I'm bringing out. And the best news is that the guys at Haydenshapes want to give away one of their new cohorts. So simply subscribe to our YouTube, send me an email directly at joyride@rollingyouth.com, and maybe it'll be you.
Made a whole lot of money at the bar. Yeah. These tables is fucked up.